First off, I want to say Happy New Year. You know, it is 2021. You know, we all made it. Yay! And it's been a minute since I made a video. So, today I wanted to tell you guys what has been happening with me and why you haven't seen any videos from me in a nice little minute. I would say about a month. So, if you read the title right, you know the terrible news. I had COVID, right? Yes, the one thing that I have tried to avoid catching since it came out. And this is mainly because you don't know how your body is going to react to it. So, not only did I want to share with you guys that I tested positive for COVID, I also, you know, wanted to give you guys some hints or maybe like, or just share with you how, you know, I got it and how it affected me. So, you guys know I have been doing very well with the whole quarantine thing, social distancing, staying away from people. Ever since it came out in March, I feel like I got a little lax, you know, because it was like, okay, I had gone out to dinner a couple times at a restaurant with my friends. And I didn't get sick, which was very careless of me. But, okay, now Thanksgiving time comes around and my mom is wanting me to come home. But, you know, my family lives in Memphis. Their numbers were terrible at the time of Thanksgiving. And I had a lot of relatives that were getting together. So I was really, really skeptical. I was like, no, you know, I'm gonna stay at home with my kids. And that's what we did. We had a really, really good at home, the four of us, James and the two boys. But, so yeah, I stayed home. I did not go. And it wasn't a whole 3 days after that that I spoke to relatives. And, you know, they had gotten it, everybody almost who went to the family gathering for Thanksgiving, and I was like, okay, cool. But I thought that, you know, by the time Christmas rolls around, and you guys, my little sister just had a baby, and I was hurt that I couldn't go and be with her and be with the baby, and you know, like, my family is super, super close, and I feel like I had already sacrificed Thanksgiving. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna go ahead and go for Christmas, because and my main motivation was the baby. You know, my mom doesn't really go anywhere, neither does my stepdad, and it wasn't gonna be a whole family gathering, just, you know, my mom, my stepdad, and everybody in the same house, and no one left or did anything like that. So you guys, I thought it would be okay. And plus, they have immunity or whatever. Not immunity, but antibodies they've had, you know, because many of them had already had it. Well, I went to Memphis. I did not leave my mom's house. And the day that I parked my car, I did not leave. I didn't go visit friends. Didn't go visit extended family. I was like, nope, I just want to hold this beautiful newborn baby that's my niece and it's the first girl. Anyway, so I did that, and then, you know, on the ride home, coming home, you know, from visiting family, because I didn't fly, trying to be safe, trying to social distance, just keep the people that was in my house with me at my mom's house. So it was like maybe 2 days after that, the first sign that I knew something was wrong is, what was it? A small sore throat, and not like a regular sore throat. It wasn't like a stinging feeling in the back of my throat. It was more like, I don't know. I don't want to say a lump because that might throw you off, but it felt weird when I was chewing my food and swallowing. Okay. So that was the first sign. I was like, hmm. So then I started asking, you know, the kids, my husband, are they having any symptoms or are feeling sick? Nobody was feeling sick. So later on that night, I was like really cold. And I kept asking my husband, hey, are you cold? He was like, no, I'm not cold. Ooh, you got COVID. That's what he said. That's the first, you know, in COVID terms, no one gets regular illness anymore. No one gets a sinus infection. No. Your first thing is I have COVID and I need to go get a test. So I didn't check my temperature that night. I was just like, okay, I'm just gonna sleep away from under the covers. So the next morning I got up and I was burning up. My fever was 102.3. And my husband was like, yeah, I'm gonna take the kids and we're gonna move into the basement. And that's what he did. But I was so weak and my body was aching. My fever was so bad that I kind of just slept all day. But I was like, I need to go get a test to make sure that that is what this is. So, called my doctor. Lo and behold, she's amazing. She ordered me a test. And it was no charge. And she was like, yeah, you sound like you may have it. Well, my husband went with me and took the test as well because we had slept in the same bed. So I was for sure, you know, like, honey, he has it. But y'all, let me tell you, he did not have it. I was the only person in my household that tested positive. So, you know, my husband did an amazing job coming in, taking care of me. I felt like the worst part of getting COVID for me was the isolation. Not being able to hug my kids, not being able to sleep in the bed with my husband for an entire 15 days. But it was, I have watched everything you could possibly think of on TV when I was feeling better and up to it. So I want to kind of list off what the symptoms were. The sore throat, a fever over 100. I didn't lose my sense of taste, but I definitely lost my sense of smell. I could not smell anything, and that was a little scary. What else did I have? Coughing, sneezing. I also had, I was on a roll here. Do you remember all my symptoms? Look.
Yes.
Okay, go.
You had, headache.
Oh, I left
fever,
that out. Okay.
Chills.
Yes.
Body aches.
Yes.
Fatigue.
Yes.
Stuffy nose.
Yes.
That is it.
They so awesome.
Yeah.
Okay, so, you guys, the worst thing was my headache. The headache was the absolute worst part of the symptoms I had in the body ache. I mean, I was bad. If I had to compare it to something, I would say my body took it on as if I had the flu. It felt like a very, very bad flu. And how long did it last? Let me just tell you. The first 4 days are very vague. I hardly remember communicating with anybody. I hardly remember eating. I just remember doing a lot of sleeping. The symptoms wore off. I would say for me, my symptoms started to, you know, kind of wear off around, I don't know, day 11, maybe day 11, I started to be like, but everybody kept saying I still sounded bad, who was calling and checking on me. I'm very grateful my family called and my friends called and they text and, you know, my really good friend brought me donuts, I know what I call it, while I was in Ronaville prison. That's what it felt like because I even waved at my friend from my window. It was just terrible. I wouldn't wish it on anybody and I feel absolutely grateful that it wasn't worse because it has definitely taken the lives of a lot of people. And I'm also going to move a little bit different. Now, what I didn't tell you guys and what was weird is, where did I get it from? I have no idea. Because nobody at my mom's house, everybody got tested. After I got tested, everybody was negative. So maybe I picked it up at the gas station or something on the way home. That's the only thing I could think of where I got it from. But, you know, I keep some hand sanitizer in my car. I wore my mask. I washed my hands. But I guess, I mean, it's just definitely easily transmittable from person to person. So, yeah, but now that I'm making this video, obviously I feel good enough to get out of bed and start to move back around again, and I'm definitely going to be making more videos for you guys. I hope this video was helpful to anybody who is thinking maybe you have some mild symptoms. If you feel in any way that you are getting sick, go get tested and make sure you quarantine, you guys, because the last thing I wanted to do was contribute to anybody else getting sick. And I'm not gonna lie, I didn't want to make the sacrifice of not seeing my family because we're so close to each other. But hindsight is 2020, and I could have really, really, really gotten my mom sick, my dad sick, and it could have affected them in a, you know, worse way. It could have been bad. But again, I don't know where I got it from. Because they do. They don't have it. So, that's also weird. But anyway, you guys, more videos are coming up. And I cannot wait to get back filming. I got so much stuff. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. And if you have not subscribed to my channel, make sure you subscribe. Because 2021 is going to be amazing here. And you want to be a part of it. And if you have any comments below, you know, leave them. If you have any questions for me about coronavirus, I guess, and how maybe something I left out that you won't answer. And if I know the answer to it, you guys know I will communicate with you. So anyway, I will see you guys in another video. Bye.
See,
I don't like the trifling kids. What are you doing with your paw? Meow, tang, 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 tang. Hey, take, 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 take.
Don't dance. You know how I feel about you dancing. Stop. You look ridiculous. What is that? What is the ending part? No, that is not a dance.
You wouldn't know these new kids' dances be stupid as hell.
They are.
Anything is a dance. And you gotta go together. Swish.
It's not swish swash, not pull the level.
Pull the jackpot, shoot the shot, spin around, clap three times. Don't let that shit go together. But they do it.